Brown County is actually the biggest county in the state of Colorado with some of the poorest resources. We serve about 80% Medicaid students. So the majority of these students, the parents don't have the abilities to get the services that they need, whether it's dental care, which we have dental here in this clinic, mental health care, which we have in this clinic. We have here to sign them up on whatever insurance we can that they may not have known about.
I'm from Briggsdale, Colorado, which is a very rural community. There's no clinic. This would be the closest for us, but it is a 45-minute drive for us to come to the kids' care clinic. I first learned about Medicaid before I had my daughter because I was 7 months pregnant at the time and lost my job and my health insurance. We wouldn't be able to afford my son's health care without Medicaid. He takes some very expensive medications and he's blood transfusion dependent.
Blake came in to see me in December of last year for a routine four-year-old physical. Typically at four-year physicals, we do hearing and vision, blood pressure, pulse, that sort of thing. But the parents brought up that he bruises easily. So we drew some blood work on him to find that his platelet count was critically low. So critically low that it's very concerning. They repeated the labs and they were very concerned about leukemia. Fortunately, that was incorrect. He does not have leukemia. He has aplastic anemia. He is getting better. He is on immunosuppressive therapy.
We've been informed that if he was not diagnosed when he was, things could have been pretty bad for him. If he would have come across a flu or any kind of infection, he may not have been able to fight it off.
With our parents that do not have transportation, can't get out, maybe feel like they don't have insurance, don't have people they can turn to, I can only imagine what it would be like if they could not go right next door to our school-based health center. My job, essentially, is to get the students here in school, and I cannot educate them if they are not here. If they're homesick, if parents are waiting to get them to another clinic somewhere across town, waiting in line, that does not help me, it does not help my students. So just knowing that I can bring them next door, get the treatment they need, and get them back in class helps us meet all of our goals.
We are here for the what-ifs. So if he has an earache, he can come in, we can check him out. Rather than having to travel all the way back down to Denver, we can do those sort of treatments here, as well as keep doing his physicals here.
Blake has a really positive attitude about all of it, and he loves Dr. Kat. He knows that she's the one that discovered that he needed some help with his blood. She keeps up on all his lab work and makes sure he's doing okay, so he knows that he's important to her.
So what do you want to be when you grow up?